Hello everyone, welcome to HTML Zero to Hero YouTube series where we are learning HTML from scratch. In last tutorial video we learned about some basic HTML elements. You can find the link in the description below if you haven't seen the previous video. And in today's tutorial we will be learning about HTML attributes. So before we proceed to the tutorial, please do not forget to subscribe my channel, like and comment. Okay, let's proceed with the tutorial now. So let's first create some more HTML elements. That's another element which we use to link the content. So for example, if I need to create a link, I'll be using a tag. Now let's create our first link. That's how we will create link. We will use tag with a and end our tag with slash a, and then we will add an attribute called href with our link and under the inverted commas for that attribute value. So that href is our attribute within our HTML element. Now let's save the document and see how it looks. Here we go, my first link is ready. So when I'll click, it will take me to my website. Yay, we created our first HTML link. Now let's go back to the document and discuss some more about the attributes. Now let's create another element through which we can add images. So for example, this is the element for adding images, and we will be adding an attribute for this element to locate our image. Now let's pick any of the image currently placed in our desktop. So let's take this one for example. I'm gonna rename it to sample so it will be easy for us to add the URL. In src attribute, we will be adding the URL of the image so HTML document can understand where to pick the image from and display it on our document. Now let's add our first image. Sorry, what was the name again? sample.png sample.png. Now I'm gonna save the document and see how it looks on the preview. Hit refresh and here we go, our image has been rendered. We can also add width and height as an attribute in the image element. So let's see how it works. So we will define width and height of the image which we added in an attribute called width and height. These are the two attributes which we are using to define width and height. Now we have defined width as in 400 pixel and height as in 400 pixel for our image element. Now let's save the document. Hit refresh. Here we go. Our image has been resized as per the width and height defined in the attribute. Now let's discuss another attribute called style. Here we can, by using the style attribute, we can define the font family. We can change the font colors. So let's, for example, change the paragraph color to red. Now I'm gonna define here color, red. Style attribute is used for defining the CSS code. So whatever value we add under the style attribute is called CSS, which is cascading style sheets. That's another language which we use for styling. We'll not be discussing much for that language, but it's just for the basic example how we can use to change the colors and some basic styling used for that. Now let's see how it works. After defining the color red, let's save the document. And hit refresh to see how the document looks like. Here we go. Our paragraph color has been changed to red. We can use the same for our heading as well. Let's see how it works on that. Go back to the document. Copy the style attribute. Paste it under H1 tag. Also, one more thing is to that attribute will always be added in the starting tag. We cannot add it on the ending tag. So for example, if I use it for the ending tag, it won't work. Let's remove it from here and add it on ending tag. As you can see, the color has also not been changed. So here you see the style is green color and it shows that the proper coding format. But here we see it's not properly formatted. Now let's save the document, see if it's worked. Save the document, go to the document, hit refresh. Here we go. The paragraph is again back to the black color, which it was on the default color before. And our heading has been transferred to red color because we added the attribute on the starting tag here. Let's move the style attribute in the paragraph element to the starting tag. Let's save the document again. Go back to the document. Hit refresh. And here we go. Our content is transferred to red color again. Now let's discuss another interesting attribute called title. That's where we will add my first paragraph. Now, title attribute will show a small tooltip when we take our cursor to the specific element. So in this case, when we will hover over our cursor to this paragraph, it will show the small tooltip which this text. Now let's save the document and see how it works. Hit refresh. Here you see a small tooltip showing up, says my first paragraph. It will only show up when you hover over it. So let me zoom in to show you guys. Now here you can see on the zoomed in mode that when I hover over my mouse on this paragraph, it shows the little tooltip which is coming through title attribute. Okay. So all HTML elements can have attributes. Depending on the name of the elements, we have different attributes. So here in this video, we discussed style attribute, href attribute for linking purposes, src attribute for adding images purposes. I think that's pretty much it for the tutorial now. In the next video, we'll be discussing some more detail about heading elements, paragraph elements, and style attributes. Till then, have a great day.